Hello, YouTubers. My name is Boniface Kanyango, and today I wanted to show you the items or the requirements for proper ambulance. So as you can see, we have the ambulance with us here. That is the ambulance that serves the hospital, Oljabet Hospital. And so today I'll be showing you the various instruments that are inside the ambulance. So as you come with me, viewers. So here, the interior of the ambulance, as you can see, we have all the necessary items that are required for a proper and a modern ambulance that is in the state of the art and that can give proper service to a patient. So here we have the oxygen cylinders that are used for a patient that is requiring oxygen. Here we have the patient monitor that is, of course, utilized by the nurse who is attending the patients. Here we also have the suction machine, which is also very important to make sure that the fluid, patient fluids, are manageable by the attending nurse and all is going on properly. So here you also have the cabinets where we keep the various materials necessary that are utilized by the nurse to make sure that the patient is comfortable. The patient, everything that appertains to the patient is proper. So this is our stretcher that brings in the patient, maybe takes out the patient to make sure that they come in and out comfortably with minimal disturbance. I'm seated on a form here, it's utilized by some nurses, also by the relatives, to ensure that they are comfortable. They can see their patient as they are transferred to another hospital for other services. So the ambulance also has the power supply that converts the AC power into DC power, maybe DC power into AC power, so that the instruments utilize the AC power and work properly. We also have the natural sphere. Especially in these times of COVID-19 and other contagious diseases, the ambulance has to be fumigated after all has been said and done. The patient has been transferred to and fro carefully and the best way possible. After that, the ambulance has to be fumigated, it has to be cleaned. So we have a knapsack sprayer to do that, to make sure that things are going on as planned. So we have the nurse seats here, the nurse seats that are attending to the patient, and the relax there. When they fasten their seat belts, it becomes a smooth ride. So that is the interior of the ambulance. And of course, as you can see, at least most of the requisite items, at least 99% of the requisite items are present here inside the ambulance. At the extreme end here, we have the dustbin. We have the dustbin whereby all the waste is deposited to make sure that it is handled in a proper manner. We have the vomiting container here. We have a patient who is not okay with vomiting. We utilize that bucket. We also have our sink here, whereby the nurses clean the devices that they are utilizing. We sanitize them so that along the way, they can utilize the devices that they have. We also have our first aid bag, carries the sedatives, dressing packs, cotton wool, surgical gadgets. They are all kept inside the bag so that they are readily available for the nurse or for the doctor who is accompanying the patient to their destination. So that's basically it, viewers. As far as the Oljabet Hospital ambulance is concerned. And of course, at the cockpit, we have all the necessary dashboard, the nice dashboard there that controls the lighting of the ambulance along the way, and also the sounds for the ambulance that enable us to control traffic along the way. So, thank you, viewers. Thank you. So that's it. Thank you.